What's up, internet land? Welcome to the Tactical Strike Media YouTube channel. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button down there or over there, somewhere. Hit the subscribe button and smash the notification bell like it was a Russian tank. Thank you to all of our supporters and everyone that has bared with us all this time. I think this video is going to require a little bit of introduction. A lot of the people watching this might know me by Acid Casualty. Some of you guys might know me by my silly social media pirate character, Captain Nobeard, or a number of other things. I manage a lot of different accounts and do a lot to, at the moment, help Ukraine. But before all this, what I was doing was music. Basically, to sum it up and make things short, I got tired of promoting myself. The whole look what I can do thing, it gets old real quick if you're not a narcissist. You know, every day setting to social media to talk about yourself and market yourself for 10 years gets fucking exhausting. So I decided to turn my record label into more of a PR machine, things like that, because a lot of people know that I used to run a few different record labels, and promoting people's music is something that I used to do. But now I market information about the war to counter the propaganda and do a lot of other things, too many to list in this video. The point of this video is too much information for a social media post. Right now I'm posting on behalf of the NAFO Clandestine Operations Group. Again, my viewers from my previous life may not know what NAFO is, the North Atlantic Fellas Organization. It is a group that came together to counter, you know, propaganda about the war in Ukraine and disinformation and the trolls and a lot of the other bad things that came along with it all. And thank you to everybody out there that's been part of the movement. It's a big thing. There's a lot of different people that do a lot of different jobs, and they contribute in a number of different ways. Some help with the charities, some fundraise, some boost content on social media, and others report TOS violations on social media, report disinformation, things like that. If you don't know what NAFO is, you know, I encourage you to Google it, look into it, you know, check it out. I don't have time to explain it all, so I'm going to try to make this video as short as possible with as little editing as possible, so everyone is just going to kind of have to bear with me and put up with my stuttering or my possible slurring of my speech, things like that. Edit. I'm going to try to make this video as short as possible. Nope. Edit. Nope. Edit. But something that, you know, a lot of people don't know about me, and I don't like to talk about it because I'm not trying to cry or bitch about it, is I was exposed to contaminated water on a military base known as Camp Lejeune when I was a child in the early 80s. And one of the side effects is Parkinson's-like symptoms. So if you see me shaking or something like that, or I stutter or slur my speech, I apologize. That's probably why. Neurological stuff. But, you know, I'm okay. Good to go. Moving on. Again, this video is for the NAFO Clandestine Operations Group, known as NAFO COG. And it's in regards to the NAFO fellows that have been losing accounts, getting their accounts locked, or getting their accounts suspended. There is a network of Kremlin gremlins, a nest of Kremlin gremlins, if you will, that have been attacking, targeting, and reporting NAFO fellows for quite some time now. And we've been keeping an eye on things and doing our best to deal with it, but a big part of dealing with things like this, like trolls and harassment, is teamwork. A big part of dealing with trolls and harassment is teamwork. A big part of dealing with trolls and harassment online is teamwork. If you see someone being targeted and harassed, please take a moment to stop and report. The best rules of engagement to dealing with trolls are typically to just block them, ignore them, and move on. They are just trying to distract you from the mission at hand. In this case, the mission at hand is countering disinformation and propaganda. It is supporting Ukraine, supporting the charities involved with supporting the troops on the front line, and so forth. Again, the troll's objective is to distract you from that, to discourage you from supporting Ukraine in any way, which is a point that I want to make right here. The people that take the time to hunt down and report TOS violations against accounts like this, what you do is a lot more important than I think is given credit for, which is okay, because no matter what you do to support Ukraine, it shouldn't be to glorify yourself or to say, you know, again, look what I can do. It should be for Ukraine, for all the people that are suffering there, that have suffered, for everyone that has lost someone there. That is the right reason to be doing this. It's not to be virtue signaling or look what I can do or look how much I can fucking donate or so forth. So, the people that take the time to report trolls and disinformation and things like that to the platform content moderators, thank you for what you do. What you do is important. What you do is super important, because if every time someone sets social media to support Ukraine or one of the charities in any way, and they were attacked by trolls that were like that, if they were attacked by trolls like I'm getting attacked by mosquitoes right now, with images of gore and death and all the disgusting crap that we are all tired of fucking looking at by now, I'm sure, then nobody would want to support Ukraine. Nobody would be able to fucking take to social media to support anything, because they would be spending all of their time blocking assholes. So again, thank you for taking the time to report nonsense when you see it. What you do matters. Which brings me to the point today. The nest of Kremlin gremlins that are targeting NATO fellas. In the replies below this post that I'm going to share on Twitter or X or Twitter X or whatever the fuck it's called now, I'm going to list a number of accounts that are targeting NATO fellows, reporting TOS violations, and getting results. Which brings me to my next point, information warfare. Not the same, obviously, but very similar to kinetic warfare. In kinetic warfare, when you're in a war zone, and you stand up and fire a fucking rocket off at a tank, you present yourself as a target. There's a trail of smoke that leads right back to you, and they can all focus their fire now on you. Right? Okay. Social media stuff and NAFO and what you do to help counter disinformation is not that different. When you post a meme or something like that to, say, TASS News or Russia Today or something like that, a priority target, that makes you the target for the trolls and everyone else like that. So always keep that in mind and act accordingly. It's like the Super Troopers thing. There's a part in that film when they say his shenanigans are cruel and tragic and ours are cheeky and fun. That right there is the key to not ending up with a suspended account or a locked account or things like that. Never engage in hate speech. The platform is now considering the word Votnik hate speech. Okay, so they are reporting every time you say the word Votnik. If they're reporting it, they can get results. So you have to be careful about that now. Again, it's important to keep the priority of targets in mind. Me personally, I would say state-sponsored propaganda, embassy accounts, things like that. That is a high-priority target. A troll with 5 followers, of which 3 are probably the same person, that's not a priority target. Fuck that person. If you are one of the people that reports trolls, that might be a target, because that person is the one that is trying to set out and degrade support for Ukraine by harassing people. So that is absolutely a fucking target. But if you're one of the fellows that prefers to post memes and shitpost and things like that all over nonsense, then ignore the trolls. Fuck them. Again, if they are distracting you from the mission at hand, they have already fucking won. Ignore them, block them, let them have their little block by badge of honor, and fuck them. Another important point to remember in regards to information warfare and what it is that you all do is the machine gun analogy. A machine gunner fires a machine gun in short bursts, 3 to 5 rounds, whatever, rather than a full mag dump, you know, 100 rounds in 1 trigger pull. That is to preserve the barrel is to keep it from overheating and melting and fucking blowing up in its face. Those bullets going through there cause friction. Friction causes heat. Heat will melt down the machine and the machine will fucking fail. Your account is not any different. Your account is the machine gun. You do not want to follow way too many people all at once. Do that in short bursts. Posting memes, same thing. Not 100 memes in, you know, 5 hours. Space it out. 3 to 5 memes at a time, whatever. You know, find a workflow that you are comfortable with without going full mag dump and just spamming shit, because that right there will get your account thwacked whether you are reported or not. Another thing is a suspension or a lock is not the only consequences. There are unseen consequences like the ghost ban, content filtering, content limiting. There's a fucking 100 of them. I think that's a good place to wrap the video up, so I'm going to shut all this shit off and get to Twitter or X, whatever the fuck it is, and get down to reporting some nonsense. And, if you want, you're welcome to join me. Again, you can find me at NAFOCOG, NAFOCOG, NAFO Clandestine Ops Group, or Tactical Strike Media. And you can join us and, you know, report some nonsense, bonk some Botnik skulls, and fuck up some Russian propaganda. Again, thank you for what you do. If you haven't already, please subscribe, smash the notification. If you haven't already, please subscribe, smash the notification bell like it was a Russian tank. Share this video with friends and NAFO fellows, and spread the good word, and hopefully we can prevent any more loss of accounts or locks and knock out some of these assholes that are reporting us. Again, thank you for joining me. Thank you for your support. Slava Ukraine.
My name is Giovanni Giorgio, but everybody calls me Giorgio.
Did I just blow your mind?